My name is Byron, the SEAT program, student energy auditing training, is designed primarily on the one-day level like this to deal with electricity. So, if we start right off, what is electricity?
Electricity is a form of energy
that we
use. Electrons?
Particles.
Okay, I like electrons in there. I like electrons, that's a good one.
Like that? That's somebody took the wire from here to that side there.
Okay, let's try that.
And it's gonna light down.
You connect one wire on one side and the other wire on the other side, and then you connect both of them to the two parts on the light bulb, and then it circles.
Excellent.
The more batteries you put, the stronger the light is.
Is it brighter?
Yeah.
It is way brighter.
Really? It would be like connecting the wire to both sides of the battery, but all we did was connect the two batteries. So it'd be as if it were one big battery, and it has more energy flowing through it. So it made the light bulb brighter.
Okay, no wait, 3.06 for two, right?
Yeah.
Wait. 4.63.
Can you explain what's going on there?
Well, I connected the negative wire to here, and I connected the light bulb to the positive, and when you connect the bulb, the light bulb lights up.
Lights. We have lights.
They came to light.
Now take them out.
One bulb in there like that, right? And what happened to the bulb?
It lit up.
It lit, right?
A little.
Okay. Now when you stuck two of them together like that, what happened to the bulb?
It got brighter.
It got brighter. When you put three bulbs,
it got even brighter. Amps.
Very good. So the flow of electrons is measured in amps. Current is amps. So we have volts, which is pressure, and amps is the amount of electrons that flow in a second. The volt times an amp equals a watt. And it's that, and that's power. That is what we're going to deal with that. And we get power by taking volts and multiplying it times amps. That is your standard everyday light bulb, right? This is the light bulb that you've been probably using up until recently. Have you all switched to different light bulbs in your house?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is hot. Okay.
About 240 degrees Fahrenheit.
That's 2% light, 98% heat. Is that an efficient bulb if you want light?
No.
It would be efficient if you wanted heat. Measures, has one of the measures bulb? What's bulb? Okay, and it measures amps, which is the current, number of electrons flowing through. It measures watts, which is what?
Power.
Okay, it measures foot candles. By definition, a foot candle is the amount of light that one candle shines on a surface a foot away. A foot away. That's why they call it a foot candle.
Take it off.
Marcel.
Take the ruler off.
Watch this. So bright.
I'm a genius. We have fluorescent. We measured 123.2 volts.
Okay.
And for the normal one, we measured 122.5 volts.
Okay, so the volts are about the same.
Yeah. The temperature in Fahrenheit, we got 115 degrees for the fluorescent light.
Okay.
And 238 for the normal light. There's a big difference there.
Yeah.
And but with the foot candles, the fluorescent light had 90 foot candles, and the normal light had 50 foot candles. About.
Oh, wow.
About.
Brighter.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, on the fluorescent watts, I got 13. And on the light bulb, I got 68.
Okay, that's a big difference, huh? The compass does what? It points which direction?
North.
And why does it point that way?
Because there's a magnetic pole.
They're the magnetic poles of the Earth. So what's inside of that then?
Okay,
I've shorted this thing out.
Holy smokes.
Oh, it's making a magnet.
And it's affecting it, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. So the electrons flowing through that wire created what?
A magnet.
A magnet. Now we had a little battery hole with a battery in it. Now let's see what happens.
It looks like regular chocolate.
Whoops.
Oh man. Voila.
It's flowing current through a coil wire like that. Makes electromagnet. Rebecca? Very good. Okay. Turning out electricity. He's a transformer that kicks it up to millions of volts. Other words is real big wires running real far apart on top of extremely tall things. Michael has been a transformer. He steps it down so that Rodrigo can run along through the countryside coming into D.C. Nathan is the wires running through the neighborhood. I'm looking kind of normal. You're come on into the house. You're going to be wires inside the house. You're the toaster oven.
Our planets are allowing.
Yeah. It's chaos. We're wasting energy.
In the power plant.
We're losing a lot of stuff.
We're losing a lot of stuff.
Okay, we're coming from the big high power wires, megavolts, to a transformer.
Wow, that's a lot of energy.
Yeah.
Why do you still have your hand? Get over here.
Because as much as they try to be efficient, they still can't be efficient.
Can we eat it?
Yeah, why do you guys do that? He's holding his hands like this.
See, all you have to do is do it.
So you're holding it like this.
Do you think the power company tries hard to get that from all the energy from the power company to the user?
Doubt it, yeah. Not really.
You don't think so? Oh, I think it's money in their pocket. They want to get out every bit there they can. But they don't, right? There's loss everywhere along the line.
So this, well, basically, all we're trying to do is to help make this school more energy efficient. Our science teacher, Mr. Hoxima, took on the initiative to start a project that would make our school more energy efficient. So this school was built in like the 1940s or something, where energy and efficiency weren't used in the same sentence. So all we're trying to do is figure out a way to help this school reduce its impact on global warming so that the world can be a better place, basically, with this one small step.
Because I want to green our school so that in the future, like, our kids and our grandkids don't live in a really polluted world, like in my own home and in my community.
Well, the course is about like helping the school become a better energy efficient school.
Yeah, we're trying to find out how we can try and maybe have a plan so then we can change all these unfluorescent light bulbs and make them energy efficient. Some of the stuff that we contributed to this plan was searching up all other types of electricity that can help, that would be cost, not only cost less, but also be better for the planet, like solar power.
Wind power, wind turbines.
We're going to like go green, like save the environment.
We're trying to like make the school use less energy and be more energy efficient.
We know that like the school uses too much energy and the electric bills are too high.
We have energy patrols one morning a week and Friday afternoon, and they go around and they make sure that all of these are set to where they should be and that the teachers know what they've done right and what they've done wrong.
We're trying to make our school more energy efficient because it helps the environment, and also if we don't waste energy, we don't waste money too, so it's good for school.